Do you use the internet? So you know what it is, yeah? How would you explain it to a complete stranger? The internet's a little bit more easier to use than it is to explain. In this video, we'll give you a clear explanation and also clear up some of this vocabulary that gets used and test your knowledge with some simple questions. So what is the internet? Well, it's a network, a very large connected network, or a network of networks if you like, and it sends messages in blocks, and we call these blocks packets. So the internet is a interconnected network of networks that sends packets across these networks, where these packets contain data. To make this work, there are many types of standards or rules that everyone sticks to, and we call these protocols. Now, protocols can be described in different layers, but we need these protocols so every device can communicate with each other all over the world. While you watch this video, look out for the answers to these questions. What is the bandwidth of this connection? We have three samples and three speeds. So what's the bandwidth of that connection? Question two, we have three sensors and they have addresses. Which of these sensors is using the correct internet connection? And finally, we have three services with their bandwidth. Which service can transfer data at double the rate of another service? Nobody really owns the internet or created the internet. It was developed over time. Now, there were some research projects, including an American defense project called ARPANET. And the idea here was they wanted to break up messages and send them very fast and send them in different locations in case there was like a nuclear attack. Now, over time, we've seen different changes and the internet has grown. We now have internet service providers that range from big, large communication companies that own and maintain the really large cables and connections all around the world, we call the internet backbone, to the smaller internet service providers that provide the internet for your home, for example. So what type of networks do we have? Well, we can have local area networks called LANs that cover an area such as your home or an office, a building, or even a school. Now, if we're going to have a network covering a large area like a country, this would be called a wide area network, a WAN. So we have LANs and WANs. Now, in a network, we may have different type of devices such as computers, laptops, phones, printers, and they're normally connected by a cable. How we connect them, the design of the network, we can call the shape or the topology. So we have different types of designs. You can see here a star topology, a ring topology, and even a bus topology. So different devices can be connected on a network, normally by cable. If you look at your computer, you'll see a cable coming out the back called twisted pair cable, which has these copper wires inside that are twisted to help send data, and these send data by using pulses of electricity. Now, there's another form of cable that's a bit more expensive but is more reliable, and that uses light to represent binary data, and that's called fiber optic cable. Now, we don't always use cable, we can use wireless. And these send data through radio waves through the air, and those are picked up by a wireless access point. So these are different ways of communicating from device to device. Now, in a computer, we might send zeros and ones by different cables, but if we've only got one cable connecting two devices, how would we send data? Well, we can send data by using slots, such as time. Imagine if we split a second up by 10 slots. Then a slot with a signal could be a 1, without a signal could be a 0. So this would be how many bits per second. Now we can actually send more than 10. We could send thousands or even millions now. This is called the bit rate. And you can see here that 1,000 bits per second we represent by kilobits per second, KBPS. Million bits, megabits per second, billion bits per second, gigabits per second, GBPS. So those are the bit rates. Now if we were to send a packet and time how long that packet would go to another device and come back, we would call that the latency. And that's measured in milliseconds. So we can think of bandwidth as the maximum bit rate. So what's the maximum amount of data we can send? That's the bandwidth. And an example of that, we've all heard of broadband internet, and that requires at least 256 kilobits per second. So what about sending data? How do we know where to send it to? Well, we use IP addresses. So here's an example. We've all seen the address when we use the internet, but that gets turned into a number. You can see here we have the number is made up of 4 separate numbers separated by dots. So we could think of our ones and zeros before, where we went up in binary numbers. So if we have 8 zeros or ones, which is a byte, that can total up to 255. Now we use them with colours. If you can remember, if you look at a screen, you have pixels, and they can be made up of colours from red, green and blue with values from 0 to 255. If all three of them were 255, that could equal white. So now we have the same idea but with IP addresses. Here we've got 4 numbers, and each of those numbers can range from 0 to 255. Now one of the great things about the internet is that everyone can use it, but that means we have billions of devices all around the world. Now the IP address that we use is called version 4, based on 4 numbers, but that can only account for 4.3 billion addresses. So that number, however large it is, will mean that we will run out. So that means we've introduced a new version called version 6. Now this has a much larger number and a different format. Now this accounts for so many addresses, and this will not run out. So we have version 4 and version 6 for these IP addresses. Now if you think of your address, if you looked at your address backwards, you would start off perhaps with the country you live in, your postcode, your area such as your state or your province or your county, then your city, maybe the area you live in, then your road. So we can think of this as a hierarchy. And we can do the same with the IP address. So we could start off with the first zeros and ones being the country and the location. And then the next may be the company, and maybe inside that different departments. And at the end, the devices in the departments. So we have this hierarchy. Now let's check our answers to the questions we posed at the beginning of the video. What is the bandwidth for this connection? Well, the bandwidth will be the maximum bit rate. So 2 is the highest. So the answer was 2. Which of these sensors is using a correct internet connection? Well, the first one is a proper IP address. Now the second one is an email address. And the third one has a number with 300 in it, which is above 255. So answer A, if you like, sensor 1, the address is a correct answer. Question 3, which service can transfer data at double the rate? Well, they're quite straightforward. They're all megabits per second, and the local service is 200, which is double 100, the first, so the answer would be local. So those are the answers of the questions. Now, do you understand this vocab? So we have different words here we've mentioned in this video. If you're not sure of the meanings, go back and look again. You should be able to understand all of these terms now. Okay, great. If you enjoyed that video, please give us a like. And if you haven't already, please subscribe.